discussion of the selection of summer finalists to interview for the city manager position. We will now bring up our consultant to the podium to present.
Strange issues that may crop up tonight in council meetings. But we are here tonight to work with you in kind of the next step in the evolution of the search process that we've been going through now for 7 months. So now you have had an opportunity after our last meeting to select some semifinals that we wanted to pursue. As I mentioned, it's not impossible to lose a few of those, so you have left the 13 at the end of the day that help continue to. I also indicated to you that it's somewhat of a heavy lift in some of the SGR searches to do some of the things that you've asked them to do. You probably didn't have a chance to see that, typically responding to a pretty lengthy questionnaire, participating in video interviews, which we'll talk about here shortly as well, is always a challenge. Well, the mayor has been paying attention to different kinds of specific levels. So it's one of those things to work your way through. The goal here tonight is now that you really have a chance to learn more about. The objectives are to try to get that narrow down to a smaller group of finalists that you all do want to participate in some sort of insight or process. We talked about that in previous meetings as well, about what that looks like, and we reconfirmed what that is, what that process for the interview election is, and the judges' assessments that are going to be so there is no one magical way to do what we're about to do here. Some councils like to talk through the process as a whole about candidates and just kind of work their way through all those. I guess that's a little bit longer than the pool is bigger than the panel. Some councils like to take what I call a thoughtful vote, not to say which ones are we most interested in. What I would tell you, no matter what process we use, my experience in doing and coming to these searches is there's going to be two or three candidates or more that all of you or most of you will identify as a number one. And then there'll be a bunch with a kind of a middle with a two or a one that there's some conversation, and then there's going to be a handful that there's not interest to continue to pursue the questions. And we don't spend a whole lot of time talking about those that everybody generally has as consensus on. You may be different, I don't know that, but my instincts tell me that's how the process normally works. We'll spend most of the evening talking about those that are kind of in the middle. And then try to do more than you advance, don't you want them to advance, what did you see?
So, has everybody stuck with the five or six?
What do we lose when we do the right time? Didn't we? We didn't want to go yet.
according to this course.
I just, I would hate for us to be so far off anywhere if your input is not certified typically and people very strongly need to be considered. We could do it where the scoring and then the genius sort of lets us know maybe who scored across the board. I know it's a little bit
sure I asked him to read that. Obviously, the people that are with me are not going to be on it. So, you could read it, so please.
Can you read it here for the record?
For the people that are listening and watching, I can't see it from the room.
We operate here by majority. Three or more votes that are cast are the majority of council's decision. Do we want to stick with the top six, or do we want to narrow it down to five, or say six? The pleasure of the council.
Narrow
it
down to five.
Do we want to put it to five? When we started this process, some of us were we're steadfast in our resolve to also offering a look at non-traditional candidates that would offer a different set of eyes to our city priorities. And I've also said to myself, we don't have to say it has to be one or the other. We can still have a candidate that can keep the wheels and the bus moving, and we can still have a candidate that also provides an opportunity for growth in a very innovative way. So I stretch my mind out as far as what they offer for the traditional candidate, that offer the city manager experience, and then there are a few that were thrown in there that I think provided some great solution architecture, that provided some outcome-driven dialogue within their interviews that I found very appealing. So this will be the most important decision that this council makes moving forward as the selection of our city manager, because we do have a lot of priorities that we're looking to accomplish. And so I would have a tough time as limiting us and taking one candidate off and not actually respecting the process and not respecting the majority of this council that we do work in a consensus building mode. Looking at these candidates, I mean, there were a couple that are shortlisted that were not on my list, but they were twos. Like, they weren't ones, they were twos, so they were still a contender in my mind, but they didn't rise to the priority of one. And so, I don't know how the rest of the council feels about taking one candidate out, but I would have a challenge in doing that. What appealed to me about him again was that non-traditional candidate was really, he was result-driven in his interviews. And when I say result-driven, he was very focused on taking complex problems facing the community in which he works in, and his outcomes were proven by the results that occurred. And I would like to hear more from him as far as an understanding of our government and the candidates.
And I would disagree with that. I'd like to hear more from the fire board and the sheriff's office and the army that you're talking to is worth it. Two plus for me. I think she has a lot of skills that's good. But I don't know how we can talk to them to make it. I don't know if they make a comment.
What we're looking for as we look at these, I mean, make a significant difference or impact on how it goes through the process. But the non-traditional candidates, again, I mean, you know, would you say there was the two that were mentioned now, the two leader and Kelly, are there anything also that would stand out in your mind that would be beneficial for us to consider as well?
I think what I've discovered, I think what I see is what the staff will do is two, we will spend anywhere in our lives. Started on that work, we will have, obviously, we'll be using it from that criminal history background stage to work. We will, I'm going to get that all the way out and call the therapy process to complete their PowerPoint, but we will ask them to complete the first year of the therapy assessment, and their risk assessment, so we can have this at all. So your next book with them will have, from the panelist's perspective, cover letters, resumes, questionnaires, and their written response to their first year game plan. And then you'll get through everything that is submitted as part of the application process. Through DISC assessments, and then you'll see a copy of the DISC assessments to be printed in the folder. If any cross off on criminal history, legal background, of course, we'll touch with the panel, and that can touch with you with any comments at that stage, so that's really good.
Thank you.
because I don't want to arbitrate the agreement to discuss them. Of course, we want to do a thorough job for a year, just because of the fact that these people are so highly forgiving. Everything that we discuss doing with the finalists and get it done in a few days, especially if one of them is, so you are in that side room with the first option, and that was for 90 minutes, 5 minutes. But my experience on most councils, 90 minutes is the right window of time, is 4 to 5 minutes. So what we normally see when that happens is we bring a second day interview and then go into the following day, which is the Saturday. And then just kind of split some of them over the room by it, and then we'll do the same thing. And we just add the extra day and then put, you know, a couple of candidates in and then go to the next one. They quite frankly would prefer to have a fresh council than to be the last candidate on it and have our day. So I think they won't fully understand that.
Well, I'll tell you, I appreciate that. You know,
And don't get these people choked up. My feeling as we clean Peter's graphic display, and this is awesome. There's a young man that has grown up in this city at the various departments, and we can mold him with the proper leadership to make him a fantastic manager. Because what I'm afraid of is he has opportunities out there. He's got credentials now. You know, he can move on, and we're going to be out of luck. I don't want to see that happen. And the fact that all of us have crossed the board, even when I didn't vote the first time and I was sick, y'all, number one, stay across. And, you know, I'm just a vote. I'm just a lone dissenter, perhaps. I understand how this works. But common sense tells me, and I forget I use that word, common sense, he's the guy. Let me ask, though, because I've kind of done this question, you know, because the way the story went, we put a lot of ones this time. There were a lot of priorities at once. I scored 6 ones, or 5 ones tonight. It's very, very unusual not to give the internal incumbent the opportunity, unless they've done something so egregious that we said no. So this happens almost every single time for what you've done in the search. It's very unlikely.
I mean, really, given that we do it in the first round as well, we selected a leader to discuss with you there in this discussion. Because if you have an internal candidate, whether it's for a finalist level or a finalist level, if candidates qualify, sometimes we have internal candidates that aren't qualified, maybe they're not even happy to pass the year or something of that nature, and that's different. But most of them get involved in a very quick development. It was fairly typical for councils to advance those internal candidates to the next round and into the next round if necessary, because you know them. So there's a familiarity, and that certainly goes to be understood. So, and I think I identified when I was a manager, and with the exception of 2 or 3 positions, there were 35 voters. I'm really, really disappointed in person who I was more than 10 to go through the process. So then I knew if he or she was my internal candidate, that they truly earned it and they got the initial boost. And if they didn't, then there was something better. So that's really the decision you have to make as a group. But what the mayor says is certainly what we see on regular
basis. Well, that's a good guess before. One of the things that I bring here, this is easy, the things that you mentioned. I sat on Marine Corps promotion boards where you didn't see the manager, you had records. And it was very lengthy, these promotion boards, depending on how many you had of that drop, could run several weeks. And I read everybody's documents. I read everybody, I saw everybody's video, and yes, there are some impressive people that have questions about that. We were not around some of them, and we're all pretty much in alignment. But I'm afraid that, we're just going to be in prayer because I feel in our heart of hearts that we know that some of those guys get. Because we can move. Like I said, we can mold it like a piece of clay. We can give them the leadership. Your background in leadership with the county government, with working as a lobbyist, all of our collective skill sets, which, you know, wasn't on COVID with the landing because he came in with all the background. So, you know, we just kind of assumed that he knew what he was talking about, yada, yada, yada. And he wasn't going to change too much in his ways. That's fine. Here's an opportunity that we can do the right thing and make this thing stand back. That's my piece. I'm not going to say anything more.
So I think we're still going to be able to do the right thing. But I think we owe the people a common sense dignity. Because we did keep it out of line also. At least we asked just some qualified people there. We got to tell the people a common sense that we keep them amongst the best. According to you and all of us, the best meeting.
What I'm saying
is that there's a few people over there, at least another 3, in my opinion, that we ought to look at. Then what you want to know something is that makes Bowie even look better.
I hear what you're saying, and I look at it this way. I'm not going to disappoint the people of Palm Coast, so I like to be. came like the man trust of my judgment and my background and experience. And that's how I looked at it. So, okay, do what you read. I'm not going to say anything. I just want to say that a lot of the pre-testament thinking and the previous ministers were on the basis of faith. And I think it's going to be an easier position to defend if we end up doing it well, that he deserved the entire process and he wrote about it. And we can say that he chose the best candidate with the alignment with the most everyone else who was chosen by our council as a whole. And he excelled, and he was the top choice. But I have a harder time defending the position that we knew Bill was the best, but we told the rest of the guys that we wanted to go and talk to him.
And that was the point. And let me just ask quickly, I think your point that, I concur with a lot of what you said, actually. I'm very impressed with him, frankly. I've got to know him. I've obviously worked closely with him. But also to Eddie's point, to Nick's point, I thought about this process a lot. It's been a lengthy process to get us here. Very intrigued by some of the candidates that have applied, and I was certainly intrigued by their background. And I really do feel strongly that we have to see this through, and let Bo compete for this position, but let him do it in a fair, open process. And I know he will do everything he has. I just really want to make sure that we are vetting every single opportunity to make a thoughtful decision moving forward on what else could possibly be out there and what we're looking at. So I really do respect your position and actually every single thing that you said, and I thought a lot about it, but I really still feel very strongly that it's going to be better.
I'll roll along with you here. I mean, you make sense. We're frustrated because we want to get this over. What I want is a full-time manager, let's rock and load, move forward. And we're kind of still trying to, we've got the reins on the boy, but we're not letting him loose to do his true thing. And I know he can do his true thing, but we're going along with him. It's all Bob's fault. Next time you go around with your point, you should be
conversations we're looking for is a different conversation that we'll see. But I do think we need to have a fair process and communicate that to the parents so that they listen to them.
It's a public meeting. We should have public input, and I would think it would be a motion. Motion would be appropriate to specifically or identify the district in the motion to move forward with the process. So I think we should have public input first.
Thank you.
as I feel that you and Paul will not be the continuation of the Christian life.
Thank you for coming, next speaker. As far as it is a flat fee count, and as far as when this will be decided, It's not 8 weeks. It's not per week. We have a 3-day session coming up in 2 weeks in which the candidates will be invited to participate by an interview process. And we will also have a meet and greet with the public. So the public will be invited to meet all of the candidates that are coming in for this. And have the chance to get to know the candidates, and then they will do a presentation before the council. And then that next Tuesday, we'll have a special meeting following a workshop to make a decision. So it will be happening in the next few weeks. Definitely to your comments about keeping an open mind. And as far as, again, the comments that were made, and I are duly noted as far as the comments about Bo.
May I make a motion? I would like a motion that we invite Bo Calgary, Donald Cooley, James Drone, Ken Kelly, Matthew Morton, and Robin Hayes back for the next round of our city manager hearing.
Made and seconded. All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Seeing none, I trust that you're not going to stay.
So we'll also move to adjourn the meeting.
Sorry. We do need to discuss. March 7th is the first day the candidates will be here. In fours and one-on-one interviews, we're going to work with the official. Thank you.
Virginia, we need to preserve that as a public record. Thank you.